right, welcome back, everyone. This is your host, Ray Hansen, also known as Big Truck. We're coming to you live from the Ultimate 10-Ball Championship in Frisco, Texas. This is the beautiful Embassy Suites Hotel and Convention Center where this event is being held at, and we are ready to rock and roll. Orietta Strickland and Brittany Bryant. This is going to be a great match. Orietta Strickland has been a force here in the Texas area with the OBQ Ladies Tour and other major events as well for a long time. And Brittany Bryant, of course, many of you know Brittany. She's a star from the Canadian women's circuit, and she is also a junior nationals champion. And here's the lag. Sense of humor from Orietta. Brittany Bryant will be leading us off. Bryant with a long shot here. It does all ball fouls.
Okay.
Brittany Bryant, junior nationals champion, 19 years old here. This young lady plays jam up, just finished high or maybe runner-up in the junior nationals event out in California recently. Great player. No stranger to the winner's circle. Brittany Bryant getting on the board first, 1-0 over Orietta Strickland. This is a race to 7. Our next match is going to be here on the TV table. It's going to be, let's see if I can remember who it was, Raj Hundal and Dennis Hatch. Ooh, that's going to be a good one. Both these guys are playing jam up. Raj played here yesterday morning on the stream table, and he was playing really well. And then Dennis Hatch, we all know how Dennis Hatch plays, took down Darren Appleton out in Vegas. They're in a big challenge match last year. And Dennis plays good. Dennis from my hometown, Buffalo, New York. But Raj is a tough customer, so it's going to be a good match. Looking forward to that one. It's coming up at 6 o'clock is the scheduled time. We are running a little behind on this match here. Brittany plays pretty fast, and Orietta, if she gets a gear going, she can play fast as well. This match may not take the full 2 hours. It's got a really just one pocket for this two ball. Has found herself parked behind this 10 ball. She'll be kicking at the 4. Tournament Director Ken Schumann rolling through the area. Wow, Oria put a little body English on that one. Didn't get there, and Brittany Bryant with a clear shot at the 4, and nice angle to get on the 5. This rack looks like connect the dots here. Angle here. Not a whole lot left to say on this rack. You know, if anything, if you had to say anything is the key shot on what's left here, it's probably the 8 to the 9 ball. That's about it. have to spin this ball a little bit here. Wow. She can see more of that than it looked like from my angle. So a shot, and Brittany Bryant is pretty straight on this nine ball. Kind of reminded me of a final rack that Brandon Schuff played in the finals down in Louisiana that he and I were in, and his final ball to win the whole tournament was the nine ball tournament, and he rolled past it just like Brittany did there and got real deep on it, and I said, well, about the only shot he's got is bank it in the side. Before I could even get that out of my mouth, I fired it right in the side. I mean, before I could even say it, he didn't even hesitate. He just bent over and fired it right in the side pocket. It was a crazy exciting finish. Well, Orietta Strickland capitalizes on the miss by Brittany. And the 10 ball spots up when it goes in a pocket that wasn't called. 1-1, we got action. It's a race to 7 here. If you're just joining us, this is your host, Ray Hansen, and we're coming to you live from Frisco, Texas, just on the north edge of Dallas. This is the Ultimate 10 Ball Championship you're watching. Christy Womack, the referee for the TV table here, doing a great job throughout the event there. Had a few tough calls, and one of them was during our last match, and she kind of went with what the players had told her, and she ended up being right. You know, it was on the one of the final racks there. Brandon Schuff had shot an obvious 9-10 combo, and didn't call it, and obvious shots are, it's not necessary to call an obvious shot. This was the ruling that Ken Schumann had made. Well, actually, it wasn't a ruling. He just kind of reviewed it, the rules with Brandon and the and Christy both after the match. Still a brutal thing. I know Kevin Guimont certainly wouldn't have wanted to have won that match that way. He wanted to win it shooting out, you know. So, I should say that rack, because that wasn't the final. It wasn't the final rack. Rack number 3, Brittany Bryant. Thank you. Hey, Brittany Bryant plays pretty sporty. I told this story a few times, but first time I met Brittany, it was Brittany and Nicole Keeney were together. It was in Denver, Colorado, and they were up at Table Stakes South, which was in the transition of becoming Billiards Inc. at the time. But I got in there the night before I set up, which is two nights before the tournament. Anyway, I got in there, and Brittany was in a match, and watched for a little while. You know, I like the way she plays. She's got a nice game. And anyway, went on to the room and came back the next day at about noon to start setting up. She was still there in the same match. She played all night long. So I had to wait because it was the table right next to where the TV table was. I had to wait for her to set up, and for her to finish so I could set up. And she finished up about her match up about 2 in the afternoon, and I guess left, went home, slept for 4 or 5 hours, and then came back and played in the tournament at 8 o'clock that night, and did the whole thing all over again. Crazy, loves action. Brittany Bryant. If you want some action, Brittany Bryant will play you. Don't care who you are.
Okay, referees, if you are not refereeing a match, I need you to the tournament desk, please. I have 2 matches that I need taken care of. Thank you.
Strickland breaking rec number 4. It almost sounded like a little miscue there. Spot here. They do have the ball spotter. Christy worked diligently to get it out and made it. She looked over at us with a sigh. From the internet chat, Swede giving a shout out to Kevin. Shorty here, going to the air. I don't think she's calling anything. The one ball really doesn't have a pocket here. Well, nice hit, but no love. Brittany Bryant will have an open shot on the one ball. That's kind of a tricky little shot here because she can draw this back into the side rail, but she's got to be sure and get on top of the side pocket. And she maybe used the nine ball to come off of. Got to have a lot of stroke to get this back on top of the side pocket. Well, she got the cue ball there. Missed the one.
Stevie Moore, will you please report the table 24, Stevie Moore.
A few nights ago, several of us from the tournament here went across the street to a little sports bar type place. It's called Third Base, and it gives Hooters the five out in the breaks. It's a great place. If you're ever up in the Frisco area, I recommend checking it out. I understand they also have one in Austin, Texas. I think Orietta's wishing she'd called that. Maybe she did call it. Oh yes, she did, apparently. She is back at the table. If you're just tuning in, this is your host, Ray Hansen, also known as Big Truck. And we're coming to you live from Frisco, Texas, just on the north edge of Dallas. Great venue at the Embassy Suites Hotel and Convention Center. You're watching the Ultimate 10-Ball Challenge. This is the Ladies Division, a WPBA satellite event.
Yeah, I'm not gonna I won't hold you to it. I'm sorry, it's just the,
it's okay, no.
You know, by the right certification thing. Of law, I have to enter, so.
Medical emergency here at the event, and we stopped play for a moment. That's why we had stopped, and someone had had an epileptic seizure up at the front here. Our referee Christy here is a first responder, paramedic. I think she said she was a paramedic or first responder. Anyway, she had to go and check out the situation, make sure everything was stable. The person is stabilized, and we are back in action here. Aurea Strickland at the table, and looks like she'll be calling the combo on the six ball here. A female, and she's fine. Paramedics are here, have arrived at the scene. You probably heard the announcement already. Thank you. just a hair off. I tell you what, that's not going to fly with a player like Brittany Bryant. She will take advantage. Play on more than one occasion, and she really does have a great game. It's a little different dimension playing on the TV table. Many of these players have played on stream tables before, but we're not your average stream table at this event. I mean, we have major lighting banks above each table. It's very well lit, and I mean, it's an obvious different situation. You have the VIP seating is all along the one side of the area. So there's some added pressure here. Looks like Orietta hit this very well. Shuff already playing another match. Don't have an update on the score. Maybe someone from the chat may be able to update me. And scroll down on your page and catch all the live scoring compliments of Jerry Forsyth and Mike Howerton of AZ Billiards. Again, our 6 o'clock match next up will be Raj Hundal and Dennis Hatch right here on the TV table. Stream number one. There's another view at it, and it's a tough shot right here. You got to really have some power stroke to get this over that fly ball, which is pretty steep in our angle as well, which is, I like bridging this behind the 10 ball. Height on this. This is one shot that is a lot easier with the handshoe jumper. She would also have a much easier time with a Steve Lomax jumper. Both great jump cues. Made very similar. Safety paid off. Are in from the tournament. First place on the women's division, the WPBA satellite event, $5,600. Second place is $3,750. Third place, $2,800. Fourth place, $2,100. Fifth, sixth, $1,450. Seventh, eighth place pays $950. Ninth through 12th positions pays $700. 13th through 16th pays 350. On the men's division, first place pays $16,600. Second place pays $9,500. Third place, $6,200. Fourth place, $4,500. Fifth, sixth pays $3,800. Seventh, eighth pays $2,500. Ninth through 12th pays $2,000. 13th through 16th pays $1,500. And 17th through 24th pays $1,100. And those are your payouts here from the Ultimate 10 Ball Championship. Wow, shot. I don't think she knew she could hit it that good even. She came well past where she wanted to go with this 10 ball. I think she's still okay. Great shot. Brittany Bryant. 3-2. Thank you. That was a very nice shot. Brittany hit that really sweet. Three ball here is in a tough spot. I'm not sure how she's planning on getting back on this three ball. She almost has to come under it or set up for a 3-9 combo. She came out with a really great angle to get on the four ball here. And this rack is opening wide open. Shy on this five, but not a problem. Just cross it back over and take the six in the bottom left corner.
Very close.
She's smiling on the outside, but she is kicking herself on the inside. Shot. Brittany Bryant making a nice recovery from a couple of position errors. Found herself right behind this 10 ball, and it's really unfortunate. The only ball on the table that could hook you, she got right behind it. Great shot. No love, but great shot. She's going to have to come with one more. With a couple of shots there. Crazy. 3-3. This is actually getting exciting. Race to 7. Brittany Bryant taking a short restroom break. Doing that, I'll give you all a little peek of the arena here. It's beautiful, beautiful place to play. This is the convention center attached to the Embassy Suites Hotel in Frisco, Texas. Bert Kennister looking on there. Bert and Orietta, good friends for many, many years. Score is 3-3, and after those six racks, Orietta Strickland has a player's rating of 680. Brittany Bryant rating at 793. Performance ratings supplied by ProPool.com. Also, if anyone would like the link to check those out live, we can post that in the chat for you. Pocketing a ball while safety, and Orietta is able to give this back, and she's doing just that. Brittany Bryant coming to the table with no clear view of the four ball. Good hit, and she got rewarded. Aurelia's in trouble here, stacked behind the six ball. Looks like she'll be going for her jump cue. Hit by Orietta. Looks like Brittany will have a clear view of this four ball, though. Tough shot, but she's got a clear view. Now the kicker is here. She really doesn't want to hit this ball soft or with table speed. She doesn't want to roll the cue ball here, so she's going to have to hit it up and down the table or maybe play it safe. Its way right through all of the pack there in the center of the table without touching anything. Shot by Orietta. Great touch. Shot here, but it's a tough one. Thank you. Great shot by Brittany. Shot on that 7-ball to take a 4-3 lead over Rietta Strickland. If you're just joining us, you're watching the Ultimate 10-Ball Championship. This is the WPBA Satellite Division. And we're coming to you live from Frisco, Texas, the Embassy Suites Hotel and Convention Center. It's a great match. It's a race 2-7 here on the Ladies Division. Christy Womack, referee for the TV arena here. She's been doing a great job all event. Had a few tough matches to call, or tough calls to make, I should say, and she handled them really well. A nice safety. Mm-hmm. a little shy. Contact. I don't think this goes in the side, but it might. And even if it does, I think Brittany will have a tough time getting on the six ball. For what I know, great shot. Got on it like it was a hanger. Impressive out there. She got a little close to the nine ball there, but came back in a stout fashion. Brittany Bryant appearing to be very focused right now. Thank you. camber and some distance. Very close to the rail. Very well made. Performance ratings for these two matches. These two players, Orietta Strickland is currently at 657, and Brittany Bryan is at 811. Thank you. Well, she got away with it. Seven ball rolled into a very tough spot. Brittany not happy with it. She really wanted that seven ball, another foot there. Came up shy. Well, Orietta hands it back to Brittany. Golden opportunity. There we go. Brittany Bryant on the hill, 6-3, leading Orietta Strickland. Thank you. Nice shot. Folks, standing by as soon as this match is complete. We are scheduled for 6 o'clock match of Dennis Hatch and Raj Hundal. Thank you.
Attention players, if you have a 6 o'clock match, please be on standby. The tables will be opening shortly. As soon as your table does open up and your opponent becomes available, we will make it happen as soon as possible. Thank you.
Players, we are going to be rolling like right away after this match is over. Dennis Hatch and Raj Hundel. It's going to be a great one. We do not know yet who our 8 o'clock ladies match will be, and then we will have another winner's side men's match at 10 p.m. All of those are stream table 1. Matches. Score updates on the Ultimate 10 Ball website are updating every 60 seconds. FYI. Nice shot there by Brittany. She's going to have one more tough one here since the 2 ball is on the end rail there. Thank you. Gloria Strickland fighting her way back into this match. She can close this rack here out 6-5 is huge. Of course, she needs them all. Shot on the eight ball here. She also has a natural billiard on the nine ball here as well. It's safe, and it looks like she is coming up a little shy. Gorietta can see the eight ball here. Hatch and Raj Handal are standing by. They are on deck waiting to come into the TV arena. They will be taking at least 10 minutes to warm up, 5 minutes apiece. And beyond that, we will begin. And she overturned it just a little bit, but got some love. Orietta Strickland, no shot for Brittany on this eight ball. We'll be seeing another safety here. Looks like this 10 might pass the 9. Thank you. put my cross bank on the 8. Nice shot. Immediately following this match, again, the players will take at least a 5-minute warm-up each, and I'm going to be refreshing things on this end. Brittany Bryan is just 1-10 ball away from closing the set out, and she's done it the hard way. She's got the cue ball right up on the rail. Now, if any of you out there haven't played on the new diamond rail system yet, this is a shot here that's a little bit easier on the new diamond rail system. The top of the rail no longer sticks up a little bit, and it gives you a nice clear bridge onto the cue ball off the rail. Still a tough shot. Well, Orietta once again with a chance to pull within one. Chain of events there at the end of that match. Brittany Bryant takes it off 7-4 over Orietta Strickland. Again, it's going to be about 5 minutes of warming up a piece. We're going to get things refreshed. We'll be right back up.